exists when all people at all times have both physical and economic access to sufficient, safe and nutritious food for, which meets dietary needs for healthy and active lifestyle. This is defined by Food and Agricultural Association. This means all the people should have economic and physical access to sufficient, safe and nutritious food for their healthy and active lifestyle. Shashank is going to take over.
So I'm going to talk about challenges. So food challenges are increasing global population, climate changes, potable water storage, obesity, loss of arable land or urbanization, loss, increasing food wastage. So I'm just giving a brief. Increasing global population with combination or with combined with climate changes increases the food security and land becomes more scarce. The global population 4.4 billion to 6.1 billion in 1980 to 2000. Projected global population is 9 billion in 2050. Degradation of arable land 75% in Central America, 1/5 in Africa, 11% in Asia. Now Harish will
continue. So, as you can see on map, approximately 500 million people across the world are obese with a BMI of 30 or above. If the people who are overweight will be included in this category, over 1.5 million people would be overweight. If nothing is done to predict this, by 2030, over 1 billion population would be overweight. Next. Malnutrition on global, this is a health care cost. $3.5 trillion or 5% of the global GDP, obesity, health care. Next.
Water security. The reliable, acceptable, and availability of quantity and quality of water for health, livelihood, and production of water, coupled with a water-related risk, is known as water security. Water is a finite resource. There is only limited amount of water present on Earth, which gets evaporated and comes back to Earth, which is known as water cycle. Now,
I'm talking about water challenges. So the planet contains about 70% of salty water and 30% of fresh water. In the 30% of fresh water, only 1.1% is usable and clean water. In other words, the rest of the fresh water is locked up in the glaciers. Agriculture uses 70% of the fresh water which is available. So if we want to increase the food security, the food water security also should be increases. Harish.
Water security is defined in world terms. 80% of the global population 80% of the global population faces a high level risk of water security. Many low income countries face greater water security risk, but have least ability to mitigate such risk through appropriate investments. Next. Least water security. So you can see on the map. It shows the least water security by the countries. Little or no water, that's the yellow part. Physical water scarcity, imminent physical water scarcity, and economic water scarcity, not estimated. Thank you.
Thank you.